All right, middle school, I am back with the second part of building your bobbleheads. One thing I want to point out, when you're not working with your pieces of clay, either the top or the bottom, and you still want to build on it more, make sure that you put it in a bag, okay? And zip tie that or close that up. I will put an empty bag in the kit that I send home with you. So just make sure you're doing that. If it does start to get a little bit dried out, use your water bottle. Give it a couple little spritzes of water. Be really careful not to give it too much water because it can kind of start to collapse on you and turn back into like almost like a mud consistency. So be really careful not to spray it too much. But if you notice that it's starting to crack or feel really dry, give it a couple spritzes of water and you can probably bring it back. Okay. So remember to do that, guys. Okay, so for my bobblehead, I have two visual references. One is on my computer and one is printed off right here. I decided to do our Pitbull Jack. You've probably heard me talk about this guy a lot. I thought he'd be kind of a cool bobblehead to do. So I have a visual reference of him that is super, super important, guys, if you want your piece to look good. Okay, I also have another picture on my computer that I just took of Jack, and it's a side profile of him, so I can see exactly like the shape of his snout and the shape of his skull, where his ears are, things like that. Okay, so I'm gonna just set that off to the side. Keep your visual reference with you. All right, a lot of people don't like to use them. I don't know why. That's just part of putting forth good effort into your work, so it makes sense to me. Okay, so I am going to use my subtractive loop tool. Jack has kind of like a dish, like his head right here is kind of scooped in towards his skull, and he has kind of a pronounced nose. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start using my subtractive loop tool, and I'm just going to start making that kind of space in between his eyes that is kind of concave. I want to be careful not to scoop down too much. I'm not really worried right now about like the fine details of the texture and things. I'm just trying to get the shape. All right, be really careful not to go too much. Every once in a while, check because you can scoop right through your clay surface. Okay, so I'm thinking that's probably good enough for now. I don't want to scoop down too much and go through it. So you can kind of see right here, I've kind of dished out a little bit right here for that area between his eyes. Okay, now I'm going to add on the area of his snout right here. If you were to see my dog from the side, he has a pretty straight bridge of his nose. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add on a chunk of clay. Now, you cannot just stick the clay on and think that it's going to stay. When clay dries, it shrinks by about 10%. Any area that you have not joined correctly is going to pop off, I promise you. Okay, so what you're going to do, if you've never had me for clay before, you're going to score. Scoring is just roughing up the surface of your clay. I'm going to rough up both surfaces. And the nice thing about this being air dry clay is you really don't have to worry about trapping in air pockets because it's not going into the kiln. Then I'm going to take just a little bit of water. Not a lot. And instead of using slip, I'm just going to use that water. And the water, when I put his nose on, I'm just going to twist it just a little bit to make sure that I've really got good contact. Kind of think of it like Velcro. And it's going to just lock onto each other. And then I can come in here and I can kind of smooth out where I've joined those two together. Okay, and now that I'm looking at Jack's face head on, I know I need to make this a lot wider. That's for sure. So anytime I want to add on more clay, I'm going to do that same process. I'm just going to rough it up. And I'm going to add this on. If I think it gets too big of a snout, I can always just subtract that off and carve it off. But I think this will be a good start to Jack's head. So I'm going to add on to this side too. Oops, wrong end. Just a tiny little bit of water. Then I'm going to score this other little piece too, just a little bit. And I'm going to add that on. Okay. And like I said, at this point, I'm not really worried about the details of my animal or anything like that, or whatever it is that you're making. I just want to get the basic shape and the structure down. Okay, so if I look at Jack from the side, it's looking pretty good. I'm going to check my reference on my computer, and I can see that like this kind of comes in, the snout comes in a little bit more. He's definitely got like a pointy nose. Okay. So I'm feeling pretty good about that overall shape of Jack. And I can kind of take my finger and kind of scoop that down a little bit right in there too. Okay, now I'm going to come in the inside and I want to push out his head just a little bit at the top. Also, one thing I'd like you to see, make sure that yours is kind of bringing your pinch pot in a little bit, but make sure that it's still going to sit on top of the base and be able to tip. Don't make this area right here so narrow that it can't bobble, okay? So you have to make this opening pretty good. You can also come in here too, use your subtractive loop tool, and you can scoop some of this out if you think that it is too narrow and it won't allow it to sway back and forth when you touch it. So just little things, okay? Okay, now the next thing I want to show you is how to do something like ears. And I'll show you too. How I would do, well, I'll show you that in another video, how to do like eyes and things like that. Okay, so I'm gonna pull out this chunk. Okay, so to get Jack's ears, what I would do is just kind of take a little bit of clay. And I would just kind of smush it down with my fingers. You don't need to have like a rolling pin for this or anything like that. I'm just going to make like a little slab of clay. Now be careful smushing it down onto a surface if you don't have a canvas mat down or something that you'll stick that to it and you won't be able to get it off of there. Okay, so Jack's ears. I'm going to have to maybe take another picture of Jack just to be able to see his ears. I'm just going to kind of take a guess on them. I'm going to pull the rest of that off. Now, if I'm looking at his ears, I'm going to kind of think he's got these really complex folds in his ears. Like pit bulls do. Ooh, I can see right away his ears too small for his head. So I would redo that. Actually, what would be a really good idea is to take a piece of scrap paper and draw the ear out. Let me get a piece. Okay, so just a piece of typing paper. And break it down into simple shapes. I'm going to start with an ear like this. Okay, I know it looks really big, but I can always trim more off of it. So I'm going to cut that out. And I know that Jack's ears don't stick up, but this will kind of give me a good gauge of how big or how small I need it to be. Okay, so if you see this guy, this is way too big. He looks like a Chihuahua. Looks like our other dog. So I can just cut some of that off at this point. Now if I was to fold it down, it's still looking too big. Okay, that size might actually be a pretty good fit for Jack's ears. Yeah, I'm thinking so. I'm gonna just kind of narrow that up a little bit. I don't want him to look like a pig. Okay, I think that would be a good start. You guys can kind of see that. All right, so now that I have this template right here, this is a trick that I've taught you guys if you had sixth or seventh grade clay with me. Lay this out, kind of smush out your little slab. Then I'm going to lay this on top of it. And I'm going to take my stylus, or I could take one of these tools. That was pretty good. And I'm going to go right around it, and I'm going to use it like a template pretty much. And because I have this paper plate, or excuse me, this paper template, I can make two of those ears easily. It works really, really well when you have something to do with symmetry. Oh, there we go. We got it off. Got a little mangled. Okay. So I think that would be a good size for an ear. So I would fold it like my visual reference. He's got these weird ears. You can kind of see them. It's going to take some work here. And I would kind of fold them on down. Okay, and before I attached it, I would score and slip it. And I'd also look at the placement of it on my side profile. Are they back more? Are they up closer to his snout? Where are they going to be? Really be looking at where you place things. And remember to score and to slip it, okay, when you're adding on details like this. To clean up the edges of your objects and stuff like that, you can put just a little bit of water on your finger. And you can just run it along the edge of the clay, and it'll really smooth out your clay. And it'll just make it look really cleaned up, get rid of any little clay burrs, things like that. And you can make that look really, really nice. Okay, I'm gonna stop the video for now with this one. So you guys work on your head and the features. I'll come back with the next video and I'll show you a little bit more about craftsmanship and how to do the body of your animal or your character. Bye, guys.